Hello guys, Anthony here, and I'm here to present to you kind of a new series I want to do. I want to do them every now and again. I think it's kind of cool, and you know, whether people can relate to this or not, you know, take it for what it is. I wanted to try something different. It's something that I've planned for a very long time, and this is definitely something that I wanted to throw in the new fall content that's coming out. So this is being uploaded within the Let's Play I'm doing right now, which is The Evil Within, of course. So obviously I don't really, you know, care because I'm just releasing it, especially because this is kind of Halloween related. Yeah, this in particular thing is something that is from my childhood, as many other things are as far as gaming. Most of it is in movies and music. But so this particular thing, every episode I want to look at something different. And kind of like not review it, but just kind of like take a look at it and just remember, just have a nostalgia trip. That's what these are. So what you're looking at is the PlayStation Magazine Disc 50. And I have several of these. I have a lot of these actually. And you might be like, well, why this specific one? Well, I could do a million videos about all of these, the Jam Pack, the PlayStation Undergrounds and stuff. Now, but this one in particular, because I just always had a really cool, like, you know, memory of it. And as I do with all of them, but this one, considering it's around Halloween, I figured I'd show it. So you might be like, well, it's November 2001. That's what it says. Well, keep in mind, as I still get magazines to this day, it's always released a month before. So you get November and October, December and November, you get what I'm saying. So, like, the Resident Evil Revelations 2 Game Informer that I got is the November issue, but they send it a month before. You get the drill. So, with that being said, they're like, alright, let's kind of make a Halloween-ish theme going on. So, when you pop in the disc, you'll see an intro that's been used before around Halloween time on these discs. It's a very cool, like, haunted ride type thing, and it goes into the PlayStation Underground logo. Really cool. But that's the thing, I'm going to show you what's on this disc, and I'm going to pretty much do it a kind of a Let's Play style of checking out everything. But as you see, the playables on here, and let's see if I can actually focus this correctly. Let's see. Can I focus this? I don't even know. It's not focusing. Yeah, if I hold it there. There you go. That's good. You got Spider-Man 2, because this was 2001. The PS2 was out, and back then I was still on both. I was on PS1 and PS2. This is far from the jackpot of PS1 memories that I have, because 2001 was when things started to kind of switch over. So this is when things started to die on PS1. But they still knew that, because the magazines were still giving away these demos, so they knew that people could pop this in their PS2 and just play it. But I still played it on my PS1, so it has X-Men Mutant Academy 2, Barbie Explorer, yeah, Crash Bandicoot Warped, Tekken 3, Spyro Year of the Dragon, which came out in 2000, Siphon Filter 2, which came out in 2000, and Twisted Metal 2. You could see a lot of these are throwaways, because at the same time, they didn't really know what to put out. There was no games coming out, so they put on a lot of old ones. The newest one, and which sold me on the game, and that's why this disc is specifically special, is the Spider-Man 2 demo, because I love Spider-Man 1. And this came out in October, originally August, but because of 9/11, they pulled it because they had to take out the last level. So I didn't get a chance to play it. And I played this disc, and I was like, I gotta go get this game, and I did. And so that's why, that's most the reason, and plus because it's got a sneak peek of Siphon Filter 3. Which I'm going to watch, because it's kind of strange to hear the differences between that and the gameplay. I always thought that was cool. Everything about this, I used to play this before I went to school, when this was relatively new in 2001. I used to play all the demos. I remember playing PlayStation Underground in 1999. I came home from like my babysitters or whatever, and I just played the issue that came, and it had Metal Gear Solid VR missions, it had Tiny Tank, and that was 99. That was the golden era of PS1, the whole 90s, pretty much 96 through like 2000 was like the jackpot of just awesomeness. Obviously around here it was like a little, it was dying a bit, obviously, it shows. But at the end of the day, I don't know. This is a kind of a Halloween theme disc, so I want to pop this in for you and show you what it's all about. And let's take a trip down memory lane. And yeah, hence the title. So let's do it.
Hello, guys. Here we go. I just booted up the PS1. Always love returning to that screen. I haven't looked at this disc in a couple years, so I'm kind of happy that I'm able to. Hopefully, this thing doesn't skip. But let's just watch the intro.
Every morning, you're handed 24 golden hours.
This is an Adidas commercial.
They're one of the few things in this world that you get for free. If you had all the money in the world, you couldn't buy another one.
Oh man, I remember watching this.
Spend them well.
Anybody had those shoes? Anybody? But here we go. This is the intro coming up, the Halloween-esque October 2001. So fucking cool. I remember playing this like in October, like at nighttime. Oh man. And waking up for school and playing this in the morning. Getting like a cart ride and stuff. So cool. I never thought that years later I'd do a video on this. Here we go. Really cool intro. Classic PlayStation CGS cutscene. Whoa. PlayStation magazine. And they used to use these in previous issues around Halloween, and this is one of them. So this is issue 50, by the way. So I have so many. I have them back from like 20. I just have a stack of them. So maybe I'll go through them some other day. But we're going to go through some of these demos here. So bear with me. Whether we finish them or not doesn't really matter. But I'm going to just show you what they gave us. Obviously what I just showed. Barbie Explorer. Crash Bandicoot. I remember just these images. Just these screenshots. You know, you got the Diaz ad. You can watch again the Site-53 ad. Let's play Spider-Man 2 because this is the demo that really got me to get this game. I mean, I love the first one, but I mean, I didn't get to play it. And, you know, I actually have a disc on here that gave you the demo. I think it was July of 2001. The game was supposed to come out. It did come out in August 2001, but it got pulled. And those are the rare 9/11 copies, which have, like, well, they call them pre-9/11 copies. The smack sounds when you click start. Only in the demo was that, and I think so. I'm not sure. As you notice, I showed the PS2 controller, as people would be playing this on their PS2. Psh, psh. And he's got his little web pits there. New game, because it's a demo. And they give us, I think it's on the city streets, right before the warehouse, I think. Oh no, never mind, they give us rooftops.
Welcome, true believers. Stan Lee here to bring you yet another scintillating tale of superhero derring do. Now it appears that trouble has found
superhero
our
derring
hero
do
yet again. So get ready for a pulse-pounding, web-slinging tale of shocking revelation.
I think this has the level of the city. But feeling nostalgic, everybody? Because I am. Holy shit. I did an LP on these fucking games, so hey, it's revisiting my channel. Like when you go to the Fantastic Four building. I wonder if they rent or own. Let's see if he says it in the demo.
Spider sense tingling.
Doesn't say it. Interesting. It's kind of cool though.
Trouble for yours truly.
All right. Love this setting. Fuck them up. Man, I ate up this demo when I was a kid. I played the shit out of it. I almost wore it out. I play this all the time. I wasn't able to get it until, like, you know, later in the fall. So this is always something I'd keep playing. I was like, oh, I can't wait to play it. I gotta go this way. Shit. There we go. I don't know what mode they put us on, but... Alright. Okay, let's see. We don't have to kill everybody here, but... This fucking thing's awesome. Where do we go? Well, the Spidey's thing's gonna tell us where to go. The Spidey compass. Come on.
I love watching me work.
I think I did an LP of this. It was a while ago, actually. 4 years ago? About? 3 years ago? But here we go. I think we go to the city streets now. It's nighttime. I'm not sure where the demo ends.
Whoa, these guys sure don't look like Boy Scouts.
There we go. Oh man, these games are fucking great.
What are they up to now?
Really? I'd always have trouble with this when I was a kid.
Against barbarians. There.
But not anymore.
Little Paint and Bondo should fix things here. There.
They made a Spidey. If they made a remake of this, oh my god, take my money now. That would be fucking awesome. The same characters and story. Because the story in these games are fucking great. And only people who played it have a true.
A setup! Huh. How original.
A true feeling, or a true appreciation, I should say, for everything.
All of you guys against me.
Bitch. The fuck with Spidey. Alright. Okay, we went in a circle.
Time to save the day. Or evening.
But man, if they made a remake of this, that'd be the shit. Oh, here we go. We have to go here.
To anyone. Time to patrol.
Do up.
Now who's gonna pay for that?
I would always have trouble with this fucking part, and I was like, I wouldn't know what to do, like how to pull it off.
How am I gonna put out this fire?
But you just go, wham!
A lot of water.
He just falls into it.
That did it. Now to find out if there's more of them.
Which we already took out everybody, so.
Spider-Man 10, Nameless Thug 0. Another shout out for yours truly. The signal from my spider tracer is growing weak. Better take to the rooftops and follow my compass.
Man, kids' games today are just not the same. Really. They just aren't. They just lack something. And it's not because, like, we're not kids. It's just, like... Games like this used to actually, like, be played by a lot of, like, adults, too, because they just love, like, Spider-Man and stuff. And it's not like that still doesn't happen, but if you guys know what I mean, it's just not the same. So it just kind of, like, it just comes to show that some things can only be done once and in a certain time, you know? The timing has to be right. I think they give us a rooftop journey. This shit's a long demo. But it sold you on the game.
All right.
That's what it was about. Demos nowadays are very few and far between, and when they are, they're not long. Some demos are short on this disc, but that's, you know, that's why I just want to explore it, because this is for anybody who has a true appreciation of PlayStation demos, which is something that's so important in gaming, I think, because it was such a snapshot of just awesomeness.
Thankfully, that thing doesn't fire on its own.
Alright. I think I gotta do the part where you take it all out. Take out all the turrets. I can't speak. Got some different looking enemy design here.
Don't look down. Don't look down.
Oh, Jesus. I remember just playing this like it was yesterday. Oh, my God. All right. Now it's time to take out these turrets if we can. Because I don't think you can progress if you don't. I'm not sure if that's this part. I don't know. I guess we'll see.
Something's not right around here.
There's never anything right in this fucking New York when you're playing as Spidey.
These guys are bent on stopping me from catching that motorcycle. Better take them all out before they hurt someone.
Yeah, here we go. What the hell? We have to web them? There we go. I think there's like one more. Total of three. Because it doesn't show. Where is it? I think it's up here. Yep. There we go. Good to go. Alright. I mean, I like how in this game, too, it was kind of like, yeah, we're not going to explain, like, why you can't, like, go down. You just can't. Like, there before it was, like, a chemical. Now it's just like, eh, it's just black. We give up. I think that's it, though. I think there's a cutscene and that's it.
One lone
oh shit.
Hero against
overwhelming they took us
odds.
In here?
I love being me.
I think this is it. I think this is it. I don't know. You just gotta take out all these guys. We'll do this. We'll do this because anybody who doesn't wanna have a nostalgia trip with me would probably turned off this video by now, so suck it.
How many of these guys are there?
Damn, they give this shit a long demo. I forgot how long this was. I do remember the city streets and stuff in the city, but I don't remember this one being in the demo. I know I beat it several times, man,
look
but it was
me
just...
go.
You miss with your grenade.
Can't be too many of them left.
I love the web, like, dive into them.
None of you guys can reach the ceiling, can you?
Oh, Spidey with the one-liners.
Hope you guys have Galactus hidden somewhere.
awesome. This game is really fun on harder modes. Because that was like the real challenge. It can be pretty difficult for a kid's game. Because they knew adults would play it, you know? Comic fans.
I think there's one more left.
Where is he? The hell is this guy? Oh. Woohoo.
What, no more? Time to get some answers.
Think that's it? Think we get a cutscene?
Sloppy, Shakuro, buddy.
We actually have the boss fight?
Yank some boxes on him.
God damn, I do not remember that. This hard thing.
Fight like a man, bug.
Oh man, deja vu.
What happened, Shocker? Walk out of electrician school.
Damn, we're gonna get raped by his shocking things. Down is up and up is down, no! It's just, this fight's always difficult because you have to, like, aim, and it's a bitch.
No, you can't have my lunch money.
Damn it! Well, if that's it, then that's it. Yeah, that's it. I was not ready for that boss fight. But there we go, that's the demo. So all you do is click the magic select button, fall 2001. Don't forget to follow the rest of Spider-Man 2. Oh, man. But that's one demo. We still got a lot to explore, a lot to bite off here. And oh, man, I love this so much. It's so cool. Look at that. Look how cool that looks. You can't get any better. They don't do shit like this anymore. Alright, let's take a look at X-Men Mutant Academy, too. Because I loved Mutant Academy games. I loved these games. And I remember playing these demos specifically for the first and second one. Oh, man. Second one was great, and the first one, but holy shit. And this came out, again, in 2001, like, towards the end of everything. So, I think Spidey 2 and this one were the newest games. On this disc, the newest of new. Versus Magneto. I have not played this game in a while, so I don't know if I'm going to do very good, but let's try to do something. Cyclops. These games were so fun.
Let's do this by the numbers.
Behold my might.
With the combos. Fucker. Bitch. That's right.
Perhaps more time in the danger room.
Remember these demos, man? They would always sell me on the game. Nowadays, people have the internet and stuff to look at stuff, but wouldn't it be cool to actually always play demos of these? I mean, nowadays. Because demos still come out for games, but like I said, it's very few and far between. Come on, now maybe you're getting a little bit harder. Oh. Did you freeze? I think it froze. Wow, it did freeze. Well, that was bound to happen. let me see if I can restart the PS1 on camera, because that's the beauty of it. This disc usually plays well. Maybe that was just a slip-up. I don't know. Well, we won, goddammit. You see what I did? I kicked so much ass, it froze the PlayStation. We won. Well, that was X-Men Mutant Academy, so I'll just skip the opening shit and we can get back to the goodies here on the disc that I love so much. I feel like nobody's going to watch this, but at the same time, I just don't care. Because this is really for not just myself and revisiting this, but this is just for whatever. I don't know. I hope people can appreciate it as much as I do. All right, here we go. We're not going to look at Barbie. The Crash Bandicoot Warp demo, we can check out because this game came out in 99, but they threw it on here. 98, actually. Yeah, I think it was 98 because Team Racing came out in 99. So, yeah, they were fucking dry on games. They're like, yeah, fuck it. Let's just, yeah, look, 98. They said, fuck it. Let's just put everything we can on this disc. Oh, it's the Wall of China level. Oh, I love this fucking level. You'd have to avoid the, like, the guy swinging the fucking things and shit. Jump over the dragons. Oh, man. These games are fucking difficult. I love Naughty Dog, though. Childhood in just these little fragments, man. I already had this game at this point, but I would still play the demo because it was just really fucking cool. Oh shit, I did not mean to do that. I accidentally dropped. But we got a checkpoint, so. That's the thing, if you touch like one little thing, you get screwed. Why are all these guys doing this at once? Why is this happening? Why is all of this going on this wall right now? And who is not fixing this wall? Like, oh, they're doing their little sliver things. Come on, Ant, you got this. I'm telling you, man, these things are tough. Because you can't stop at all. They pretty much like throw you into enemies. Oh my god! I remember the one I had, the demo I had from 98, it had the underwater level. Which is really fun. Just shooting at shit. The blowfish and stuff. Made it. And that's that. That's the demo. I said, here you go, bitch. There's a demo for you. It's like, at this point, if you haven't had this, gotten this game, man, I wish I could just go back in a time machine like this fucking game has these warps, and you can warp to different times and just play this all over again for the first time. Because there's nothing like the first time of everything, of anything. Yeah. But, you know what I'm saying, all jokes aside, you know, so, Tekken 3 is Tekken 3, I'm gonna try to show you Siphon Filter 2 real quick, which I'm gonna do a Let's Play on sometime soon, I don't know, of all of them, actually, I'd like to, especially the first one. Siphon Filters are my favorite games of all time, one of, I mean, Siphon Filter is up there. I used to play these games all the time when I was a kid. The third one was coming out when this demo disc was released, so it was appropriate for them to give you the last game, I guess, that came out. So, yeah, here we go. This is the infamous train level, which is very fun to play. All the demos, there's a bunch of Siphon Filter 2 demos on every fucking disc in 2000, and all of them are the same, and I'd always play them. And that bar, that blue bar you just saw across the screen, was always a glitch in this version of the demo. Always. Always a glitch. You okay? I've noticed that. It's about time you checked in.
I've been better. My adrenaline shot is wearing off, but I've got enough strength to come and get you.
All right.
Man, these games are the shit. Talk about shooters. When shooters are really, really good, they don't make them like this anymore. All right. Get the shotgun. And the shotgun did not look like this in the final version. I believe it was the blue one that everyone remembers. But in the demo, for some reason, they just never fucking did anything with it. So, oh, man, this was the level. I remember, look at that. The stepbrother has a pixel glitch in this demo version only. Not the other demos on the discs, but everything else. And the cool thing is when you aim, it does this weird first-person stuff. That was not in the final version of the game. And I don't have ammo. Why? Oh my god, I'm dying. Yeah, I died. I was not ready for that. Okay, let's try to do this right. And there's no blood when you die. It's just the bullets. Like, they're afraid to show everybody it. Okay, we get it. Alright, so I forgot that I should just all use shotguns at this game. But all the levels and shit, I know, like, the back of my hand. As I know this game as well as any Resident Evil that I am hold close to my heart. Because these games were, this and Resident Evil were like my shit. Spyro, Crash, Spidey. Ready for the sniper shotgun? Sniper shotgun! Yeah! Yeah, you could fucking snipe people from a mile away with this thing. Here we go. Triangle jumps up because Gabe can just fucking jump like it's nobody's business. This guy's chucking grenades. Like a boss. Man, there is nothing I remember, there is nothing like this fuck disc, man. Oh, God. Not just this one, but several. Does he float? Yes, he floats! He still does it years later! If you shoot him just right, he lands in the middle of this thing. I always just laugh my ass off when I was a kid, because that was never in the final game, only in the demo. But man, all these demo discs are so nostalgic! I'm sorry, but this is just how I act when I go... Look at that! He flies! There we go. You're dead, and then we can just always do that with that guy. He will never shoot you. Oh, man. These games and these demo discs, man. Only a couple people that I know... that I've known in my lifetime can really appreciate these for what they are. I don't know if any of my viewers will appreciate this video in general and understand why I'm overreacting like this, but holy shit. God. That's what I love. I can always revisit it no matter what. It's just the demo. Not even the real game. Like, before the full game, it's like the demo is awesome, you know? Even though the game was out at this point. That means you gotta headshot him. But we're not gonna do that. He's gonna kill himself. Bam. He's dead. So. Alright. Now we got a lot of M16 ammo. So we're about to go in this night vision tunnel. Which is very fun. This whole train sequence is fucking amazing. Here we go. I don't think you guys are ready for this. Shit's about to get real. It's coming up. He puts on the goggles in a blink of a second. Who's shooting me? Did I miss somebody? Must have. You can do these rolls. Oh, never mind. I guess this demo didn't have the night vision. That sucks. The other demos did have the night vision. I remember this one having it. All right. Well, he's supposed to put on night vision and just shoot people in the tunnel, and that was that section, but I figured something was off. There you go. It said Spring 2000. The game's out over a year and a half now. But the Siphon Filter 3 video that they had was very different. The gun sounds were, like, different. Like, the pistol sounded like a machine gun. Only if you played the game you'd understand, but this is a video preview. Because this issue did come out before the game came out, and I was excited for this game. I was like, I can't wait to play it. Like, that gun did not sound like that. That did not sound like an M16. Like, the pistol just sounded like an M16. Like, what the fuck? Oh, man. Even though this was a prequel and it got criticized, I loved it. Here we go. Ready? Sound like M16. Cannot sound like an M16. That video is so nostalgic, and I remember opening that in the mall when my dad got it. But yeah, we could take a maybe look at like Tekken 3, just for the fuck of it, even though it's from 98. Another game from the oldest game on here is Twisted Metal 2, 97. 97. But once we do this, I'll get out of here. But I just wanted to showcase this demo disc, man. I mean, it was around Halloween when I did it. So maybe that's why I decided to do this one first in this series. Alright, so here we go. Tekken 3. Last demo we'll look at. I know I'm running over. Well, I'm not really running over. I wanted to show this, so I don't really care how long it is. But, alright, we gotta click start. They only give us two characters. I think it's Eddie and, however you say that name. But we'll do this. Man, this demo was on Jam Pack 98. I remember playing that and Jersey Devil on the same fucking disc. This was my favorite Tekken. There has never been a Tekken that's as my favorite as 3. A lot of people argue that it's like, you know, 4. I love 4. But man, Tekken 3 was my shit. I don't even know if I'm going to win this battle. But for the sake of the video, let's see if we can. Eddie with his fucking kicks, man. I should have been Eddie. He's really good long range. I did a Let's Play on Tekken 3. Yeah, I did. On my old channel. And I just got fucked up there. Yeah, this bitch is not as good as Eddie. Yeah, maybe because I just suck with, I probably just suck with her. Bitch. Alright, last round. Final round. Ready? I love that. Final round. I'm trying to grapple him if I can. Your fucking kicks, man. Yeah. Yeah, game over. Oh well. You lose. Alright. Yeah, that's that. I don't even think we can actually back out from here, which is kind of weird. Maybe if we actually, like, play again, we can back out. Like, if you click select.
Round one. Fight.
No? Okay. Well, in that case, I'll turn off the, turn off PS1, because that is it. Alright, well, that's pretty much all I wanted to show you about this disc. I just thought it was really cool. This is a new series I want to try out, so let me know what you guys think of this. I want to do it with other games that are not even Resident Evil related. They don't have to be anything. They can just put anything I want, so I hope you guys enjoyed this nostalgia trip, as this was kind of like a Halloween-themed disc, so I thought it was perfect to revisit it. It was really fun, as you heard my reactions, fucking Spidey 2 especially. A lot of nostalgia behind this disc, a lot of nostalgia behind a lot of these demo discs, and anything PlayStation 1 era related. But anyway, guys, that's it, so enjoy the rest of the Halloween season, and continue watching my Evil Within Let's Plays if you haven't yet. So yeah, that's it, guys. I will catch you in the next one. See ya.